the idea of why it's important to be working with an experienced agent. And I think that sort of publicly out in the world, people are like, the housing market's on fire. I'm just going to put a sign up for sale by owner. We tried that and it was like crickets. Okay. Which I believe y'all are all in cahoots on some of that, but that's another, that's also another maybe episode. But it absolutely, and especially in a market like this, when you think everything is so easy, now the complexity just ramps up because the speed ramps up, the timing ramps up, all of those moving parts are happening at lightning speed and at higher valuations. So the anxiety is higher, the sort of value of where things are keeps moving, and as just a normal individual, like, there's no way I could manage that.
Right.
You know, it's kind of like when the stock market's just booming, everyone's like, I should be my own stock market guy.
Yeah.
Right. I don't need a financial planner.
Right.
It's like, well, this is now. Okay. But there are other times in your life when things are going to be moving around and there's a lot of pieces outside of your financial plan that are going to impact that. You need to be able to navigate all that stuff together. And that's similar to what you're talking about.
Right. Yeah. You're exactly right. Like, financial planning is, you know, that I often talk about that and how it relates to this is because, you know, there's plenty of information out there on how to, you know, buy stock, you know, and do everything. And there's plenty of information out there. You can put a sign out in the yard. That's you can it. Do it. And so, you know, there's plenty of information that lead people to that point. But I really and truly say it is not getting somebody to look at your home, to see your home. Cause it, you know, we use digital marketing and stuff that other companies use that you can see, but it really comes down to when we find somebody that likes your home. That's when our job starts. We do market and we do all that thing. And, right. You know, a real estate company, really and truly, I own a marketing company. I don't own a real estate company. I own a marketing company. And
your job, I mean, the marketing is almost like, that's the commodity of it.
Right.
I mean, and when I look at what we do, the portfolio side of things, the executing of trades, that's the commodity. Anybody can do Robinhood or E-Trade or whatever.
Sure.
That's the commodity of it. That's not actually where the value is
right.
for our clients. And it's very similar.
Right. And so when we get somebody that sees it online and says, that's the house I want, that's when our job starts. I feel like, you know, it's ushering them through the complexity of the next 45 days and the emotion of the next 45
right.
and what this really looks like, because a home inspection can be scary, you know, and
it's not good.
No, yeah. It can be scary.
Yeah.
It can be scary. And you know, the appraisal, the title work, the, you know, we had a question the other day about, you know, there's a graveyard on a piece of property that we're actually selling. And you know, really and truly, what is the ability for the family members that want to visit that graveyard? What, you know, what obligation does a new buyer have?
What do you do
have?
If there's a graveyard? Are you, I mean, can you, you can't just, can you, I mean, is it a great, like, all right, how many people are buried?
15.
That you, okay. So you know, so headstones and everything.
Yes.
Okay.
So new
so
owner.
So it's a real graveyard.
It's a real
it's
graveyard.
It's not like just
right.
papaw.
If there
the
is not access to it, they can appeal to the county to okay. get access to it. But the homeowner can stipulate times and dates and everything
really?
Else that they can do it. But, and then removing the graveyard is extremely expensive.
So you can do that though.
Sure.
Never mind that the house is haunted, which is a probably right. not on the flyer, but it right. has to be at this point.
But these things are the things that we see every day. Okay. We don't like to put that on the flyer about, you know, ghosts and, you know, any problems that we might have. But the sales manager that was at Coldwell Banker before I started, right? I mean, when I started, said, if you've done one transaction, you've done one transaction. Because that's, they're all different.
Oh,
and they
yeah.
all have their right, own twists
right.
and turns. And every one of them, you know, we do 1,200 sales every year. And every one of them is completely different.